I was fed up of seeing, like, you know, four white dudes on stage sing about fuck all.
19-year-old Birrugan is the frontman of Dispossessed, an Indigenous punk metal band, giving a big up yours to the lack of diversity in the Aussie music scene, with band members from the Indigenous peoples of Ghana, Australia and Chile. Music is just another front in their fight for Indigenous rights.
You're in an Aboriginal space now, so you need to shut the fuck up and listen. We are Dispossessed, but we started this so we'd not be dispossessed no longer. That and done.
Wait! That's my father! I'll be touched!
Birrugan, thanks for joining us on The Feed.
Thank you very much for having me, Laura.
So Vice recently called you the most important band in Australia. How did it feel reading that headline?
At first I was like, this is like the most sensationalistic bullshit I've ever read, ever. I don't feel right within myself being given this title because this is dismissive of so many other Indigenous acts and Indigenous artists across the nation, like people like Ancestress, people like the Vocals.
Other famous Indigenous bands, you know, Yothu Yindi or Gurumul, their genre is more accessible and more open.
Yeah.
Why did you choose punk or metal to get your message across?
I took it upon myself to make it a sort of positive thing, to make it an outlet where I could move these sort of negative emotions that I feel as like a young black man and transfer them into something sort of beneficial and beautiful for all. I've always loved playing guitar since I was 10. And it's been like my only lifeline and my only reason to live many times. And this band has been too as well. Like when we started it, like I was crazy. It was in a bad way. Like this is all I had to live for, being like homeless and squatting and just in this mad sort of fury and fire. That's when the band formed.
We acknowledge that the carnage and the mayhem faced by the many other black nations, what is known as Australia, all started here.
You have a very controversial way of acknowledging country. Why do you do it that way?
People do acknowledgements. It's done in an often very tokenistic and extractive manner. It's about getting across to those fathers that have come to see us to understand, like, you know, whose land they're walking upon, what happened to those people.
Always was, always will be Aboriginal land. Never was, never will be the butcher's apron's land.
In your gigs, you do call out people for not being engaged with the local Indigenous community. What do you want to achieve by that?
Just want to bring them on side. Really, that's it.
Now, I've got a question to ask you all in the room. How many of you went to the Keep Sydney Open rally?
Right.
The fact that that is a movement that cares more about drinking and smoking and exerting your hedonistic privilege than your care for your fellow human being, I think that's disgusting. But that's just me.
Do you think that's the most effective way to bring people on side? People say it's very provocative.
Yes, I do, because they're not going to be provoked in any other manner.
Are you in any way worried that the experience of your gig is so full on in your face that you're going to alienate the audience and they won't take in your message?
At times, yes. However, they're either with our people or they're not with us.
Now is the time for us to unite.
You have been pretty critical about the lack of diversity in the Australian music scene in general. Do you feel like you see any other bands that are like yourself around?
No, probably not, eh? But this is the thing, like, punk and metal, like, were started by black people. Like, I was fed up of seeing, like, you know, four white dudes on stage sing about fuck all.
Now, you do sing and speak in your mob's language, Gumbangir. When did you actually start learning that?
I started learning Gumbangir when I was around the age of around 8.
What is it like trying to write lyrics for like a punk or metal song in Gumbangir? Is there any translation issues? Or?
Yeah, there's a lot. I try to sing something about like striving for justice and for peace. However, like in a Gumbangir, Bijar sense, we don't actually have words for justice or peace.
Dadindan, thank you all, Mom. Have a good night. Spirits be with you. Yadi yadan.
What's coming up for the next year for Dispossessed?
Well, we're really excited to be working with one of the members of the Drones on our next album. We're just gonna take on the world and we're gonna keep on doing what we're doing and we're gonna like be deadly. To the point where hopefully like we're not dispossessed anymore. I'm not sure if you
want
to kind of, that's the end term goal, that's a long term sort of thing. Like maybe our children can start a band called Repossess. No, again, I don't know.
I like it. Birrugan, thanks for joining us today.
Pleasure. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, everyone. No.